Hello all. Now, let us try to see the concept of motion of an object in the straight line. In our daily life, it is an essential quantity to observe the change of position in the given frame. That means the object going to be changes its position either with respect to frame of time or with respect to the frame of observer. So, the motion can be predicted by just comparing with the another one only. There is no chance for absolute rest and absolute motion. Example. We are all imagine that our friends or relatives definitely all are at rest compared to you, as a earth as a frame of reference. That means we all exist on earth. So compared to your neighborhood person, you are at rest. But is it true? Earth is completely rotating. Therefore, you need to move along the earth. That means there is no chance for absolute rest. Similarly, there is no absolute meaning of motion. That means these two are completely relative terms. Anyway, the R&D work means research and development work from the ancient days. There exists three type of things in the mechanics: static mechanics, kinetics, and dynamics. In the static mechanics, we deal with only the object which are at rest compared to the frame of reference. The kinematics is a branch of mechanics which deals with the completely motion of objects, that's it, without knowing its reason. Whereas dynamics will try to deal with the motion by exploring its cause. Why objects will move? Cause. So that cause is not able to explain by the concept of kinematics. Anyway, we are constrained to only kinematic behavior of the motion. Further, the motion of object divided into three important structures. Let us see one by one. The first one is translatory motion. Second one is rotatory motion. And the third one is vibratory or vibration motion. There exist three types of motions: translatory, rotatory, and vibratory. In some books, that rotatory motion is a special case of translatory only. Like that, some books it was represented. Anyways, to make a kind of simplicity or to understand simply, let us try to divide the motion into three strategical points: translatory, rotatory, vibration. Translatory means a linear motion. Anyways, in the linear motion or translatory motion, what characters need to be studied here? What are the characters you need to be deal here? Number one, first one is, what is meaning of position and time? Number two, distance, displacement, number three, speed and velocity, number four, acceleration. So, these are the things need to be studied under the translatory motion. Especially we need to deal this translatory motion. In the case of objects moving along x direction, objects moving along y direction, no combination here, okay, only individual is x direction and as well as y direction. So in x direction how parameters will change, and in y direction how parameters will change? Position, time, displacement distance, speed, velocity, acceleration, that's it. In what way we need to analyze this entire situation in the examination? In the examination, examiner will try to ask you about a direct formula based questions or a graphical question or some variable motion type of questions, like some functions they will give you. Either you need to do integration or you need to do some differentiation. Sometimes they will try to ask you the relative motion. So any kind of questions can be framed from the x direction motion and as well as y direction motion. Anyways, now in this particular session, let us try to see the concept of position, time, distance and displacement. Number one. So, we need to deal with position and time. See, what is meaning of position and time? With respect to observer only, we have to define the position of an object in the given problems. Example, in the coordinate system, this XYZ coordinate system, imagine that here is an observation point having coordinates of X1, Y1, Z1. Then the position of the object is represented by R bar, which is equal to XI plus YJ plus ZK. This will try to represent the position of that particular object. And next term is nothing but time. Now, it is an interesting thing. Time is a scalar quantity and it is invariant. It is a non-variable. It is a non-variant. Time cannot be changed. It is a non-variant term and independent of frame of reference. How? Let us see. Let us consider that two frames. First one is S1 frame. Next one is S2 frame. A particle is going from position A to that of B. During this particular transition condition, whatever the time taken in the frame 1, that must be always equal to that of time taken by the frame 2. So, such a way that time can be plotted. Therefore, time is independent of the frame of reference and it is a non-variable. You cannot change and you cannot write down a negative time during the problems. That means, if you are plotting the time versus any one of the function graph, then minus x-axis is not allowed. Time cannot be negative. You cannot say minus 10 seconds. It is not possible. So, time cannot be a negative one. You cannot do like this. And further, in the concept of position, sometimes you need to express the relative comparison between the positions. Imagine that this is the object A and this is the object B. With respect to observer S1, the position of object A is very less. It is very near and the position of object is far. Whereas, in the another frame of S2, the position of B is very near and position of A is far. Therefore, for the same position of object, we have different type of scenarios. Sometimes it is very near, sometimes it is very large. Therefore, it is very difficult to define the absolute position. Therefore, you have to express the position always with respect to certain imaginary or a realistic or a real-time observation points. Example, you are moving from one place to another place on two-wheeler. Then if you are updating your position to your parents or your friends, in such a case, you can define that during the journey, just traveled about 2.5 kilometers, I was at this so-and-so location and I will be there within the time like that you will try to express. That means you are comparing the position with respect to your position, means bus or two-wheeler or anything. That is your position. Comparing with what? Absolute frame, which is at outside the system. Okay. So, if comparison is not there, means it is not possible. Because throughout the journey, you are there with the bus or you are there with the two-wheeler only. Complete the journey. Therefore, you cannot define. That means there is no chance for absolute position. But you can define a relativistic position compared to other frames. That's it. Anyways, now let us see the concept of distance and as well as displacement. Second concept, distance and as well as displacement. Distance is nothing but simply a scalar quantity. Displacement is nothing but a vector quantity. It asks only magnitude, how much you travel. It will includes magnitude and as well as direction. That's it. Example, you went to home from market. During that case, I specified a direction. What is the direction? You travel from market to home. I just specified the direction. And suppose I said that it is about 2.5 kilometers. Direction also given and magnitude also both are given. Then it is called as a displacement. Suppose I just given in another case, that person walks. I don't know who is that, but a person walks about 0.5 kilometer. I just given a coordinate. 0.5 kilometer I just given. Means in what direction he is going? I did not specify. Therefore, that will come under the concept of this particular case, distance. And moreover, sometimes a displacement can be a zero quantity, whereas distance cannot be zero. Displacement also be negative and distance cannot be. So, it cannot be a negative quantity. Very, very important thing. The relation is that distance is always greater than or equal to that of displacement. Okay, we got all this picture. So fundamentally, how can I identify distance and as well as a displacement? How to identify? To identify distance and as well as displacement, we need to use the definition like this. What's the definition? The length of the trajectory. The length of trajectory. Or we can say length of the path is the simplest definition. Okay, let us take length of the path followed by object. And the definition of displacement is like this. The shortest length. Shortest length between starting and as well as ending points. This is called as definition of the displacement. Now, after completion of first one and as well as second one, we need to take care of the next important statistical thing. In the examination, how can I identify distance and as well as displacement? That's the biggest question from students community. Let us see few examples. For example, we have some different paths moving from position of A to B, represented by S1, S2 and as well as S3. In such a case, S1, S2, S3 all are called as distances. And S2, which is the possible lowest value, that is called as displacement. This is the shortest one from starting to that of ending one. Example 2. For example, there is something like a building having in the form of a C section like this, or something like a U section like this. Then here, this is about some A distance, sorry, length will be A, and here length will be A, and here the length is A. Now, a person starts walk from A to that of B. So, from this corridor to that of this corridor, that particular person travel like this. Then how can we measure distance and as well as displacement? In this case, one can measure the distance given by length of the trajectory. Up to here A, again A, again A. Therefore, 3A, that is the distance. And what is the displacement? The shortest length. So, this is starting point, ending point. Shortest length means this one. So, this gap is exactly equal to A. Therefore, displacement is equal to A. Let us see one more example. Example number 3. Suppose there is a square shape landscape and a person starts walking in the morning time. So he starts from A and he would like to exit from B. So the trajectory contains a length of same L. Imagine that this is about L, and he is about L, and this is about L, and this is about L again. Then let us try to identify the length of the track. So this is the length of the trajectory what he followed. Therefore, distance of journey is equal to this length is L and this length is L. Therefore, distance is equal to L. And I need to calculate a displacement. Displacement means what? A to B, this is called as a displacement. So if I try to prepare a kind of triangle like this, this is A and this is A. Here 90 degrees is there. No doubt that is A square plus A square. Therefore, displacement is equal to root 2 times of A. So that is the displacement during this case. Next. Example 3. Let us consider the some interesting case. This is something like some simply mathematical approach. That's it. Something like a mathematical analysis over the circles. How best your concept with circle? Let us check it out. So, in the given case, initially objects starts from A and then enters to the position of B in the circular track. So, these are the diametrical perpendicular points. These are the two diameters of the circle. So, these are the two exactly perpendicular diameters what we have. Now, the question is that what is the distance and what is the displacement of the system? Let's try to compute. In this particular case, object travels from A to B. That means it is about one quarter of the circle, that is the length of the trajectory. Therefore, in the case one, distance and displacement. Let us see one by one. ST means starting point, C1 means case 1. Okay. Distance is about 1/4 of the system. Okay. Or length of the trajectory. This trajectory is in the shape of what? Arc. Therefore, length of the arc is nothing but what? Radius into angle at the center. Radius into. What is the angle at the center? Pi by 2. Therefore, pi r by 2. That is the distance. The case 1. What's the displacement? No doubt that is shortest length. This is the shortest length. So this shortest length value is equal to, is called as hypotenuse. This is radius r, this is radius r, therefore hypotenuse. Hypotenuse means what we write down here, root of r square plus r square. In such a case, you can write down as root 2 into r. In the next case or in the next situation, imagine that simply this is our observation point. That means during this particular case, this is the case 2, C2. Let us take this is case 2. Now, at this case, now this is our observation point B, not this one, this one, B. So, object travels like this. Same to same. The case 2, radius into angle, this is theta 1, this is theta 2. Theta 1 is 90 degrees and theta 2, this is about 180 degrees. In such a case, what is the theta 2? 180 degrees, that means pi into r. Pi means 180, r means radius. We got the distance. And how to calculate displacement during this case? To find out the displacement during this case, the A to B is a straight line. So therefore, you can add simply r plus r is equal to 2r. R plus r, which is equal to 2r. This is called as displacement during this particular case. And least but not last. Imagine that object is at some other place. Okay. In such a case, it makes, suppose it is rotating in what is this direction? Anti-clockwise. Now imagine that it is rotating in the clockwise direction. So we made here first calculation like this and then second calculation. And third calculation we imagine like this. Suppose object will move in this direction. And substance, an angle of here, an angle of theta degrees at the center. Theta degrees at the center. Then, how can we calculate distance and as well as a displacement? No doubt that is in the case 3, r into theta, there is no other alternative. Simply, length of the arc we need. Length of the arc, matlab kya? Length of the arc means radius into angle at the center. Therefore, r theta we had read. And then how to find out displacement? So, from here to here, you have to plot a line. Straight line like this. You have to find out this particular red color line length. To find out this, we are just constructing small geometry here. We are doing some angular bisector line, green color angular bisector line, which makes an angle of theta by 2 and as well as theta by 2. This is the position B already we have. And this middle imaginary position is C. Therefore, we have AC plus CB length we have to take here. And both are identical. Therefore, 2 into AC length we can take modulus. But what is the opposite side here? This is the hypotenuse. This origin is O, hypotenuse R. So, when we try to plot the graph, this is the radius. I don't know what is this. But here angle is opposite, theta by 2. Here AC. I need opposite side. Opposite side is equal to, opposite side is equal to sine theta by 2 into, can I write down as hypotenuse. Hypotenuse means capital R. Kindly look at here. The right angle triangle. Take the sine theta by 2. Sine theta means what? Opposite by hypotenuse. Therefore, opposite is equal to sine theta by 2. So, upon writing, this value will be 2 into r sin theta by 2. This is the required target answer for calculation of distance and as well as displacement in this particular case. And in the case 4, let us see. Case 4. Now suppose there is something like a hill station or inclination direction theta. A man walks up to here and then return back. In such a case, what is the distance traveled by the person and what is the displacement of the person? In this case, if the x is nothing but base and h is nothing but height, distance of journey is equal to, I need the value of hypotenuse, okay, because it is right angle triangle. Hypotenuse is equal to what we write down here. We can take either sin theta or cos theta, anything we can take. Sin theta means what? Sin theta means opposite by hypotenuse. Therefore, hypotenuse is equal to h by sin theta, which is equal to h cosecant theta, which is also equal to cos theta. Let us take cos theta means x by hypotenuse. Upon cross multiplication, x by cos theta, which is equal to what we write down here, x into secant theta, we can write down. So distance traveled by the system is equal to either 2h cosecant theta, or this is also equal to 2x secant theta. You can write down any one of the formula as a distance. And how do you compute the concept of displacement in the last case? Displacement is how much? The starting point and ending point both are same. Therefore, there is no displacement becomes zero. That means a person walks from home to that of market and then he returns back to home. During this case, distance cannot be zero. And displacement is equal to zero. This is only the possible case. Sometimes examiner will give confusing case. Is there any chance to have displacement is not zero and distance is equal to zero? Never. Okay. Displacement is equal to zero. Distance cannot be zero is the condition. Okay. Please take care. And very interesting thing. And the last one is, so we have a note. Let us see. How do you calculate the displacement? For example, this is the starting point. This is the ending point. And this is the ending point. Let us take this is the ending point. We need this is the ending. That means we have four type of ending points in this case. Now, you are going in this direction means displacement is positive. You are going in this direction means displacement is positive. Suppose you are going in this direction means displacement is negative. Now you are going in this direction means displacement is negative. Okay. We have totally four instructions. So to determine the displacement, you have to use sign conventions. Very, very, very important thing. Now let us see a small example during this case. Here is the football. Okay, this is the ball. You apply little force. What happens? Object will move like this and stops. Then displacement is from here to here. It's a positive case. Now, you apply a little bit larger force. Then it moves here and then returns to here. That means the starting point and this is ending point means you need to measure. So this gap is called as positive displacement. This is the case what we have to take care. But object is reflecting. Some of the parameters are going to be negative, which we'll discuss in the forthcoming sessions. Next, project a ball in vertical upward direction. Then it goes in the y direction, or sometimes in books it given as z axis. Anyways, no problem. It going in vertical upward direction. Okay. In such a case, you can take as displacement y as positive or h as positive. Suppose a ball is falling during written condition, you need to take y as negative or h as minus sign. Height cannot be negative, but sign is given for only displacement conditions only. We are dealing with the displacements here. Okay, please take it as a mandatory thing. Now, suppose you are here, you project this particular ball towards the stationary wall and then ball written back. So in such a case, what happened? This is starting point and this is ending point. You are measuring in this direction, starting to ending is a vector quantity. You have to measure like this, then displacement is negative. Or otherwise, you are at this particular point, this is the wall, and by looking towards the wall, you project the ball in backward direction. You are seeing towards the wall and project the ball in backward direction. In such case also, we got the negative displacement. So these are the sign rules to take care of positive and negative displacements. Okay, let us see one vector picture so that you can understand the full figure configuration for the displacement. Example, these are the coordinates we have, x, y, and z coordinates. What happens, you know, we are imagining that there is something like a cube. Okay, we'll see that cube example later. Before that cube, let us see this particular simple example. As per the figure, a particle changes the coordinate system x, y, and z axis, starting from, this is the starting point, and moves like this, and moves. I'm just giving the coordinates here. This coordinate is 0, comma a, comma 0, and this coordinate is a, comma 0, and this coordinate is a, comma 0, comma 0, and this coordinate is a, comma 0, comma a, and this coordinate is 0, comma 0, comma a. These are the coordinates are given to you. Now we have to find out the distance and as well as the displacement followed by the particle at this particular case. Wow, an interesting thing. Object is moving from the point A and exiting at the point B. Therefore, you have to write down the vector form. R final is equal to 0i plus 0j plus ak. R initial is equal to 0i plus aj plus 0j. You have to do the subtraction so that you can find out the position, the vector, displacement vector. So final position minus initial position vector will give you displacement of the system. Therefore, minus aj plus ak. You can make as common minus j plus k. This is the displacement of the system. And what is the distance traveled by the object? Length of the trajectory. From here to here, length is nothing but a. And so let us find out whether this length is a or not. Final coordinate minus, this is called x1, y1, z1. x2, y2, z2. How to find out the gap between the two points? X2 root of x2 minus x1 whole square, y2 minus y1 whole square plus z2 minus, a little bit in this formula. Upon doing, we got the value of a, and a. Therefore, the total value will be equal to a plus a plus a plus a. Therefore, distance of journey is equal to 4a and displacement is nothing but a of minus a plus k. Like this, you have to calculate the displacement. Sometimes examiner will give you by indicating with the directions like north, east, west, how to do displacement. Let us see. In calculation of like directions, always you have to take top up. This is the direction as north, and this is east, and this is south, and this is west. East represents always positive I direction. South indicates minus j, and indicates minus I, and this indicates plus j direction. So these are the directions we have to take care. Now, initially, a person walks 3 meters along east, 4 meters
along the north and 1 meter towards the west. How to solve this particular case? So in such a case, this is 3i. Okay, let us try to prepare first of all a vectorial picture so that you will get an idea. What happens? 3 meters. So therefore, he walked about 3 meters. That is nothing but 3i in this direction. 4 meters towards north. 4 meters. 4 meters towards north. 1 meter towards west. 1 meter towards the west. So this is the imaginary diagram what we got here. Now the question is, what is the distance? You have to add it all. 3 plus 4 plus 1. We will get an answer. And how to find out the position of the system? Position coordinate. So this is 3i. 4j you can take it as. This is minus 1i. So he remembers just only 1. Therefore, what is the gap from remaining gap is nothing but 2 is the gap. Therefore, in the coordinate system, this is the first position, 3 comma 0, and he traveled about 4 meters. Therefore, 3 comma 4 is the new coordinate here. And then what happened, you know, 1 meter towards west. That means he would like to travel only 1 meter. Therefore, he is coming like this, back direction. This is about 1 meter only. So therefore, 3 minus 1 is how much? 2. Therefore, 2 comma 4. So y-axis value. Now in such a case, starting point is nothing but origin and this is ending point. You have to join this. This is called the displacement. Okay. Now this length O, A, B, C. This entire length is called distance. Displacement means OC bar represents the displacement. Therefore, the displacement vector is given by simply 2i plus 4j. This is called displacement. If anybody will ask you direction, direction means what now? Alpha is equal to simply written as tan inverse of, you can take alpha, tan inverse of, what is the y coordinate? 4 by 2, cancel 2. Therefore, tan inverse of 2 you have to write down. What is opposite side? North. Therefore, north of, adjacent side is what? East. Therefore, north of east. Tan inverse 2, north of east is the direction of motion. So, like this, we have to be computing the problems.